Hello, I'm Ty Mason from the diabetescouncil.com, researcher, writer, and I have type 2 diabetes. Today I'm going to answer the question, is vitamin D good for diabetes? But before we get into that, make sure you download my free diabetes management book, which also includes a diabetes grocery shopping guide, foods to eat and avoid, by clicking the link below. I remember vividly as a child milk coming in those waxy, cardboard-type half-gallon cartons. Am I aging myself? Well, on the side of those cartons, I would always see a picture with big letters that said vitamin D. I had no idea what vitamin D was. I didn't have a clue. All I knew was my mother told me it was good for me, and I had to drink my milk. Well, to this day, I still love milk, the blue kind, not the red. Well, vitamin D is often called the sunshine vitamin. Why? Well, basically because it's produced in your skin in response to sunlight. I know what some of you are thinking. I was told to drink my milk so I could have healthy bones. And that's true. Vitamin D is responsible for bone health because it helps your body absorb calcium and phosphorus, two of the main bone-building materials. Now, vitamin D is more than just for bones, however. A 2011 study by the Mayo Clinic concluded that vitamin D also played a positive role in cardiovascular health. It helped multiple sclerosis, allergies, asthma, infection, depression, psychiatric health, pain, and, wait for it, diabetes. The American Diabetes Association recently published a study that stated a deficiency of vitamin D has been linked to the development of diabetes, both type 1 and type 2. Evidence shows that vitamin D improves glucose tolerance and improved insulin secretion. A study published back in June of 2007 concluded that insufficient vitamin D and calcium was detrimental to the proper control of blood glucose. Now, that study was conducted by Anastasius G. Pettis for the Journal of Clinical Endocrinology and Metabolism. The conclusion of the study stated that vitamin D and calcium insufficiency may negatively influence glycemia, whereas combined supplementation with both nutrients may be beneficial in optimizing glucose metabolism. So, is vitamin D good for diabetes? Well, yes, it is. Evidence is growing while scientists truly don't understand why vitamin D and calcium play a major role in stabilizing blood sugar. Then the question comes, how do I get more? One great way to get vitamin D won't cost you anything. Michael Hollick, a researcher for the New England Journal of Medicine, concluded that, quote, 5 to 3 minutes of sun exposure between 10 a.m. and 3 p.m. at least twice per week on the skin of the face, arms, back, or legs without sunscreen is usually adequate for vitamin D synthesis, end quote. Now, the problem is we have this fear of skin cancer, and that's caused us to lather on so much sunscreen, our skin can't possibly absorb any vitamin D. The skin will not absorb sunlight through a window or glass either, so staying indoors and trying to get it through sunlight won't work. Drinking whole milk is a good source of vitamin D and calcium, but also contains sugars. So here's my suggestion. As always, consult your family health care provider and discuss supplements. Vitamin D and calcium supplements are readily available in most stores and online. Again, before taking them, consult your health care provider. I hope this answered your question, is vitamin D good or bad for diabetes? Don't forget to get your diabetes management book by clicking the link in the description box below. And as always, let me know if you have any other diabetes-related questions. Thank you. I'm Ty Mason.